Welcome students to my channel. Last class we have seen about if-else statement. Today we are going to discuss about a nested if-else statement. So let us start. So here it is a if-else statement only, but here we call it as a nested if-else. What do you mean by the term called as a nesting? Nesting is a process of inserting one item into another item. It is called as a nesting. So let us assume that there is one small box which we are going to keep it inside a big box. So how many boxes we have now? Two boxes. One is a bigger box, another one is a smaller box. So what we have been done? We have inserted a smaller box onto a bigger box. So this is what the concept of called as a nesting. So here I have taken only with two box as an example. Now let us see its syntax everything. So here, this is the definition, nesting definition I am telling. Inserting one if statement into another if statement is called as a nesting of if else. So what we can say that if anyone asks you a question or for you people to get understand, a nested if else statement, we can consider that inserting one if statement into another if statement is called as a nesting of if statement. So when we are talking with the syntax, see, for simple if there was only one syntax. Even for the if else also there was only one syntax. But for the nested if concept, we are having various forms of a nested if else statement. That I will be explaining to you people. So this nested if else statement, we can also call it as a hybrid if statement, because in seeing the particular syntax only we will come to know that we how in the what form we are going to use. So based on that we call it as a hybrid if statement. So now let us see the first syntax. So for you people, no need to remember all the different types of a syntax, just you remember any one syntax and implement on it. So what happens is that I have been shown you many number of forms, means different problems will require different types of a syntax. We can't say that only one syntax will be applicable for different programs. So depending upon the situation or else depending upon the program requirement, we need to choose a particular syntax. So here this is called as a form one. Form one is nothing but this is a one syntax what we can consider. So here what we are doing, if condition one. See, first look at the particular syntax. I am having, this is a if with condition 1. Inside the if condition, see students, as per the last class, this part we call it as a true block and the else part we call it as a false block. So in the true block, in the last part we used to write only the statements, but here what we have written, we have written inside a true block one more if conditions here. In the if condition 1, if the condition 1 gets true, then it will enter into the body of the if statement. This is called the selected. See, I have been selected, right? The blue color what it is going to display, it is called as a body of a if statement. So inside this body of a if statement, I am having one more pair of a if else statement. I repeat here, I have been used one more pair of a if else statement. So how this is going to work now? If the condition 1 is true, then only it will come into the body of the if statement. In that, again it will check with the condition 2. Suppose if the condition 1 and condition 2 both are true, then the statement 1 will be get executed. If statement 1 gets executed, remaining part of the if-else statement will be get skipped. So this is what the concept of a nested if-else statement. So what I have been done then? I have told you only one scenario. So let me repeat here. If condition 1 is true and even if the condition 2 is also true, statement 1 will be get executed. Suppose if condition 1 is true and if condition 2 is false, what is going to happen here? See, it will be executing statement 2. See, this part is similar to your if else statement only. Only thing is that in one if, we have been written another if else statement. So in the second part, if the statement 2 gets executed, again the nested if else comes out of the particular block. Suppose in the another case, if the condition 1 itself is false, it will never enter into the if condition. Directly it will come for the else part. See, in the else part I have written if condition 3. If that is true, statement 3 will be get executed. Okay. Now let us see the form 2, another way of writing a nested if else. See, first look at the particular syntax. So here if condition 1, That means the body of the if statement consists of only if statement, whereas else statement consists of a pair of if else. See, if you slightly observe here, see, I have been reversed this part. So if else, I have written in a else part here, and whatever I have been written in the else part of the first one, I have been written mentioned in this part. So here, what is going to, how the particular program executes? If condition one is true, then it will enter into the body of the if statement. So the body of the if statement consists of only here simple if statement. So again, if the condition 2 is true, then statement 1 will execute and comes out of the nested if else. Suppose if the condition 1 is true and condition 2 is false, I have not written any else part, so it will not come execute any part, it will directly come out of the particular nested if else statement. In the third scenario, if the condition 1 is false, then it will enter into the else part of the particular outer if statement. So in this else, I am having a condition 3. Now, which are the conditions will be executed? If condition 1 is false, it will come directly to the condition 3. If the condition 3 is true, then statement 3 will be executed and it will come out of the particular statement. Suppose if the condition 3 is false, what is going to happen? It will execute statement 4. So here I have not written statement 2. Why I have not written statement 2? If you need, you can put there one more else and you can utilize it. Otherwise, not required. Just this is an another form of writing a if statement. So this is another part here. See, there is a again difference. See, in the if condition 1, I have written only statement. I have not written any of the particular if part. So if condition 1, statement 1, 1 execute. Suppose if the condition 1 itself is false, then it will come directly to the else part. In the else part, I have been used only the simple if statement. So condition 3 is true, statement 3 will be get executed. So like this, we are having various forms of a nested if else statement. Now let us see the flow chart. So this is the flow chart. Here Boolean expression, nothing but a condition. So if the condition 1 is true, then see here towards the left hand side, we are having the body of the if statement. So it will enter into the body of the if statement. This body of if statement, again it consists of a nested if statements. So again, if the condition is true, it will going to enter into the true part, and again the statement will execute and comes out of the if statement. Now here, if the condition got failed, it will execute the false part, and again it comes out of the nested if statement. So when this part will be executed, if the condition is true. Suppose if the condition 1 got failed, it will enter into the body of the else statement. So again in the else statement, we are having one more if condition. Again that if condition is true, the body of the if statement will execute. By chance, if the condition 2 is false, what is going to happen? Body of the else part will be get executed. And later on, it comes out of the if statement. Okay, now let us see one example. So first I will be showing one example using if-else statement. The same program, we convert that in the fashion of a nested if-else statement. So let me take up values. Int x is equals to 20, y is equals to 30. Just I am taking some two coordinates, x value as a 20 and y value equals to 30. So I am going to implement now if x is equals to 20 and y is equals to 30. So I'm going to print printf, printf okay. So what is the if statement I have written? If x equals to 20 and y is equals to 30, I'm going to print coordinates are matching. Else, I'm going to print f not matching. So this is what the particular code. This I have written using a if-else statement. And here you need to remember that I have been used a logical operator. Which logical operator have been used? AND operator. What is this AND operator? How the AND operator will work? If x equals to 20 and y is equals to 30, if both the value got match, then I am going to get the output as coordinates are matching. Suppose if any one of the value do not match, then I will get output as not matching. So this is a program I have been written using a if else statement. Now the same program we convert in the fashion of a nested if else statement. So how to convert this in the fashion of nested if else statement? So first let me remove this, or let me make a comment. Yeah, making as a comment. Okay, now I'm showing you how to write the same program above code in the nested if else. If x is equals to 20. So I'm not checking here this particular using a logical operator. I'm going to write if a body. Inside this, I'm going to write if y is equals to 30. Then I'm going to print printf, printf. So I will just copy it here. The statement I'm going to copy it. Okay. So what has happened here? You might have understood here. Else, again, I copy this statement. Okay. So, yeah. So then the previous example, both the conditions have been written in a single line, but in a nested if else statement, I have been written as a part of a outer if statement. So now this if x equals to 20 is considered as a condition 1 and y is equals to 30 is considered as a condition 2. When the condition 2 will execute, only if a condition 1 is true, then it will enter into the value what that is 30. Now let us run the program. So what we should expect the output now? We should expect the output as coordinates are matching. See here, I have been got here coordinates are matching. Why I have been got coordinates are matching? Because initial I have given initial value of x equals to 20 and y is equals to 30. So now both the values are matching. That is the reason I am getting coordinates are matching. Now what we do is that we will change the value and we will see it. So now this x value I make, let it be a 20, and I make y value as a 300. See what is happening here, which is considered as a condition 1, x equals to 20, I am making it as a condition 1, y is equals to 30, I am making as a condition 2. So what is the value have been changed to 300. Now what is happening, x is satisfying, but y is not satisfying. So now let us see what we can expect the output. See here, this is what in the syntax I have been told you, statement 2, else but have been got missed. See, why I am not getting any output, do you know? Because here I have written if y is equals to 30. See, x equals to 20, it got matched. What is the value of y? Y is equals to 300. 300 equals to 30. No, the condition got failed. If condition got failed, this particular if statement do not have any else part. Is it clear? So that is the reason it has came out of the particular program. So now what I do is that, in the another case, I make y equals to 30 and let me make x equals to 200. Now let us compile the program. See, I am going to get it as a not matching. So why I am getting as a not matching? Because the condition 1, that is x equals to 20, here itself the condition got failed. So that is the reason it is coming for the else part. Is it clear? Suppose for this if statement, if you put one more else part, then you will be getting an answer for the options. Otherwise, it's not required. Only for the demo purpose, I have been showing you this particular example. Now, let us see one more program. So, I am taking int a is equals to 1. Here, I am taking only one value this time. So, I am going to write if a is less than 10, and in that, I am going to write if a is equals to 1. So I'm going to print a is equals to percentage d comma a.
So what I can do is that slash n end here. So for this if, I'm going to write a else part. Printf value is greater than 1 slash n. See, if you remember, in the first example, I have been not written any of the else part. Now I am writing here else part. This is what the difference you people can observe here. So the if part has been got completed. Now I am going to write a outer else part. So here I am going to write printf value is greater than 10. So I have not written any of the if condition inside the else part. So now let us see what is the output we are going to get. Before seeing that, see, once again let me tell you, I have taken a value as a 1. 1 is less than 10. Is the condition is true? Yes, condition is true. If the condition is true, what happens? It will enter into the body of the if statement. What is there inside the body of the if statement? There is a one more condition. Now again, what I'm checking here, a value. What is the value of a? 1. 1 is equals to 1. Yes, that true. Condition is true. What I'm going to get the option? A is equals to 1. Once if I get a is equals to 1, do we get the output of these two lines? No, we won't get any of these two lines as an output. Only one line will be get executed. Now shall we see this particular example? Okay, let me compile this. So can you see here? I have been got a is equals to 1. Why we have got a is equals to 1? Check it here. A 1 is less than 10. Condition is true. So it is entering into the body of the if statement. 1 is equals to 1. Again, the condition is also true. So what it has been done? A is equals to 1. So let me run with a different value now. I am going to write here a value as a 2. Initially, I have made it as a value as a 1. But now what I am making, I have made it as a value as a 2. What is the condition occurs here? 2 is less than 10. Yes, the condition is true, like a previous one only. But here, earlier a value was 1. 1 is equals to 1. So I got the output as a is equals to 1. But now what I had done here, made it as a 2. 2 is equals to 1? No, it is false. If it is false, what I am going to get here? I am going to get value is greater than 1. Shall we see the output now? See, the value is greater than 1. I have selected here, the value is greater than 1. Why I got this particular statement? I have been got it from the body of the if statement. Basically, the outer if statement, this is the what? This let we consider as a statement 2. So now whatever I do is that, I will make this a value as a 20. Basically, again, I have been changed the value of a equals to 20 for the third time. So 20 is less than 10, the condition is false because 20 is greater than 10. So if the condition is false, the whole body of the if statement will be skipped and it will come directly for the else part. In the else part, what I am going to get here? Value is greater than 10. So let us see now. See, value is greater than 10. I hope you people have been understood with the second example. Is it been cleared with the second example? Okay. Okay, we will see one more program. So what is this program is going to do? Program to find the person is eligible to work based on his age. So what we need to do is that in this particular program, we need to find the age of a person. Based on the age, we need to consider he is eligible to work or he is not eligible to work. So here while working with this particular program, I am considering minimum age is up to 18. And maximum age I have considered it as a 60. So if the person's age is coming within this particular age, then we consider him, he is eligible to work. If the age is less than 18 or if the age is greater than 60, that means retirement age I have taken it here it as a 60, then we consider he is not eligible to work. So this, let me start writing a program. Let me make this as a comment first. Okay. So for this particular program, how many variables we need? We need only one variable, that is age. And what should be its data type? Yes, correct. It should be an integer data type. Is it being clear? So no need to take here float. So I am taking int age. I am not giving any value here. So we are going to accept dynamic values. That means if you refer my previous videos, the link will be given on the above there. So there you are going to learn printf and scanf. I am going to give the value based on printf and scanf. So int age, enter your age. Scanf percentage d comma percent age. Do you remember here? If you have any of the particular doubts regarding printf and scanf, so on the top of your screen, click on the I symbol, you get a information regarding printf and a scanf statements. So now I'm going to write a logic here. If what I need to do now, what is the condition we have taken here? So person should be 18 years to 60 years. First I am writing if age less than 18. If any of the person's age is less than 18, I am going to print a you are minor. Basically, I am going to display the message as a you are a minor. Else, in this I am going to write if age is greater than or equals to 18, and so let me remove this, and age less than or equals to 60. So what I am going to do here, printf int, else printf not eligible to work, end it. So let me use slash n. Okay, so this is what the particular code have been written in the particular program. So now let us see what will be the output. So now based on the particular value I am going to get here. So I am going to compile the program. So it will ask me first to enter your age. So I enter your age. So I am entering the age as 10. See why I am getting here? Because the age value I have taken as 10. 10 is less than 18. Is it been true? So 10 is less than 18. The condition is true. So because the condition is true, I am going to get you are a minor. The same thing I have been got here as a output. So now let me run the program once again to check with another two outputs. So let me run this. So I am going to enter the age as a 35. So if I enter the age as a 35, what we can expect the output? See here, the age value now I have taken as a 35, because in the output here, see here, I have given a age as a 35 as an input. 35 is less than 18, condition is false. If this is false, it will directly come for the else part. Again in the else it is checking 35 is greater than or equals to 18. Yes, this in this part, the first here I am used here AND operator. This AND operator consists of two parts here. First I am checking age, that is 35 is greater than 18, yes, true. And 35 is less than 60, yes, both the conditions have been satisfied. What I will be getting here? Eligible to work. So let me enter here. Enter. See here, I got the output as eligible to work. Now suppose if I execute once again and I want to get this particular statement as an output, what I need to do then? I need to give the value of the age greater than 60. So here again I am running the program. I give it as a 62 now. What should be the output now? The last line, not eligible to work, or you have reached your retirement age. You can also give it as you have reached a retirement age. See, not eligible to work. Okay, we will see one more last example based on this particular nested if else statement. So here we are going to find aggregate of a student. So to find this particular aggregate of a student,
So what I'm doing is that I'm taking one variable int agg. Aggregate is nothing but an average. So if you want an accurate value, take it as a floating value, or else I am taking here it as an integer value. That means I am going to check only with the round values. Is it clear? The whole numbers only I am going to check. So what is the program there? I am going to check whether the aggregate is lie between 0 to 90 or not. So for that I am taking here printf, enter your aggregate slash, then I need to write scanf percentage d comma ampersand agg. So I'm going to write if agg is greater than or equals to 0 and agg is less than or equals to 90, is it clear? Then it should enter into the body of a if statement. If agg is greater than or equals to 80 and agg less than or equals to 90, so what I'm going to print distinction. I'm going to print it as a distinction. So once after printing that particular distinction, again I'm going to write if agg is greater than or equals to 60 and agg is less than or equals to 79. So I'm going to write printf first class. So what I do is that to make this particular program small, I'm going to write it here one more as combined one. I'm going to write if agg is greater than or equals to 0 and agg is less than or equals to 59. I've been just combined it. If you want, you can write it in detail also. Try next time. Okay. So here outside I'm going to write else printf enter score between 0 to 90. Okay, so this is what the particular program here. So what is the program I am doing here? I'm taken on variable called as an agg, that is nothing but aggregate. I'm asking a value for it. So based on the particular value, it is going to check. So for example, if I give the aggregate value as a 85, so 85 is greater than 0, yes, and 85 is less than 90, yes, true. So what is going to happen? It comes into this particular if statement and I'm going to get it as a distinction. Once the distinction has been got displayed, the remaining part of the statements will be get discarded. So like that, we will be working with a different option. Suppose if I give the value as a 69. So 69 is greater than 0 here and 69 is less than 90. Then which grade I should get here? This particular part. I should get it as a first class. If it is less than the particular 60, is it clear? That is 0 to 59. If any particular value is coming within this particular range, I am taking it as a try next time. Instead of taking as a second class, pass class, I made it as a try next time. Suppose if I give the value above 90, I am going to again give a statement, enter the score between 0 to 90 only. So this is what the particular program. Now let us see what will be the output of this. So it will be asking me to enter your aggregate. So first let I want a distinction. So I am going to give it as a 85 and I am going to press enter. See, I got it as a distinction. So why I got a distinction? 85 is greater than 80 as well as 85 is less than or equals to 90. See, in order to get individual grade, we are writing this particular if statements. Then you might be having a question, then what is the use of this particular if statement? What I have been written here? This is what it will be checking the range. Is it clear? The first if statement checks for the range, and this particular if statement will be checking for individual grades. Is it clear? So don't get confused here. If you have any confusion here, you can comment me. I will clear it in the next class. So once again, I will run the program. So this time I will be giving it as a 75. So what I should get it as? I should get it as a first class. So once again, if I run the program, so I want to get it as a try next time. I want the output to be displayed as a try next time. So I'm giving it as a 35. See here, I got the output as try next time. Just analyze how the particular code is going to work. You will come to know the particular output. So let me run once again a last time. So what I'm going to have here, I want to enter score between 0 to 90. So what I do is that I'm going to write it as a 96. See here. Now you understood why I have given this as a range. So I have kept the range only from 0 to 90. It is not, you should keep only 0 to 90 depending upon your requirement. Here to show you how the nested if else is going to work, for that purpose I have been taken this option. See, it is going to tell enter the score between 0 to 90. So these are the various examples we have been seen on the nested if else statement. If you have any particular questions, please comment it. I will try to solve it in the next video. And if you have liked my particular channel, please subscribe and share. Thank you.